Okay. So look, Bishop, I'm sorry, but for now, just keep away from me, please.
You know what that means. We're following this guy, okay? What is up with him? He's doing his own investigations. He's going to Global Ops? Yeah, I'm gonna follow this guy for a little bit. You never know what you're gonna find. By the way, I do remember where the brig is now. That's where we subdued Angelov.
Hello, Bishop.
Hello, Steve. What? Am I the only one hearing that? What's happening? What is going on? I'm freaking out. Does this fit the bill?
Yeah, it does. I'll let everyone know to stay away from those.
A voice in my head.
Three more now. Thanks again for the help, by the way.
You know what he said at the end? Or the voice? So aside from repeating security lockdown initiated, they said, hello, Seeker. What? Several weeks before his death, but someone obfuscated the title so that you can't be searching for it. Henry, if you are receiving this, I am sorry I cannot reveal my location or contact you directly, but I am not taking my chances. You must understand, my friend, that I had to leave you or they were going to kill me. I know that you are still having problems understanding the concept of death, but I also know that you do not want me to die, so forgive me. And help me. I need to find as much information on what the church knows about you, about us, as I can. I'm going to get us some help, Henry. And then, we're going to expose them for what they're trying to do. Please work with the Seeker you were telling me about the other day. Do not be frightened by them. If they are in fact conscious entities you are unable to reject, they could be either very helpful if kept happy, or very dangerous if made angry. Work with them and trust them only until they break that trust. Remember that you are a very special being, Henry, one that always acts with compassion and generosity above all else. I know you remember what I taught you. It's time to exercise those teachings. I'll try to help you and your Seeker update it through messages using the same method. I just hope that you're actually picking this up. So the walls of this so-called motel I'm in right now are practically carpeted in cockroaches, but I'm safe. Finally, I've been jumping from bus to bus for almost 2 full days, and I think I finally just lost my tail and can get some bloody sleep. I'm so damn tired. My god, it's so hard to believe how things have turned out. First, Patricia telling me the truth of their intentions, then Sarah getting caught in the middle. Poor Sarah. Why the hell didn't Mother make her come with me? Tomorrow, I'm going to see what I can do about getting a flight to Ireland and finding Alana. I just hope she can pull some strings for me. Not to mention, she still owes us a favor. Huh. I think to call the Boyle family stubborn would be the understatement of the year. I just hope she's at least willing to listen when I get there. Your friend, KC. Okay. I have a feeling that this article, very deliberately, it was made for us to find. Because usually when you search one keyword, it's not very common that you only get one article back, I don't think. So this is definitely something special here. KC. Do we have any KCs on our crew? Pawn 51? Pawn 51 Kendra? Kendra, no. No. Yeah, Consortium Queen. Human counterpart to the King. That's how I realized that the King is an AI. Okay, forget about that. Oh! I'm not sure what's going on here, though. KC. Who's Henry? Henry. Oh my god, there's a lot. What about this one? The Truth, Part 1. We just went through the first batch of test subjects. Test subject 1 was killed. The other 5 subjects were done in by prelim testing, with Henry as basic motor skill tests failed across the board. They all died. Subject number 6 died about an hour ago. Right before testing began, we think the MC was somehow deactivated or faulty in some way. MC? Control of the subject returned to her for a period of about 5 to 6 minutes. She was terrified. How come they keep inserting 21, 21, 21, 21, 21, 21? Remember the satellite that we took to get here? There was a number there too, it was 21. But I'm not sure what that was. What if Henry can actually read their thoughts? Could he make them speak too? Who is Henry? Obviously, there's some deeper lore going on here, but I'm not sure if we can find this out. Oh my god. Hello, I'm 1221. What is this mumbo jumbo? There are secret hands at work behind the scenes moving us toward their ultimate goal. Enslavement and control. Guardians! The Guardians and the Consortium. They seem like two factions that we have to be thinking about a little bit. Obviously, we're part of the Consortium right now.
Virtual trainer not accessible by order of Night 15.
Is Steve still around here? Why do I only hear that around Steve? Should the terminal be doing this?
No, it really shouldn't. Though, that one could be related to the damage we took when Angelo shot up Mission Ops. Alright, well, just 2 left. I can already tell it's worse than I thought.
I'm really not sure what's going on, but every time we go near Steve, it seems like we hear these weird messages. Yeah, I don't- oh my god, I don't know what he's doing, but it's making me feel weird. Can we get some more here? Yeah, see? When we're here, no one's talking to us. But whenever we get near Steve. Let's try again. See? Here, we don't hear anything. Again! Something is weird with Steve. And frankly, it's freaking me out. So, I don't. Does locking me into a cabin count?
I'd say so, yeah.
Oh.
If this is a virus with a purpose, then it having access to door locks is likely not a good thing. Only one more and I'll head to the cockpit to figure this out. I'm almost done down here anyway.
Can you open this for me? Make the return to... what? Make the return to Salus Op or something? Save us all! Make the return to save us all! Oh, that is spooky. I don't imagine we'll find anything, but... can we do... no, we can't... Save will be too common. We won't find anything. Yeah. Save us all? Return? Nah. Yeah, let's forget about the console for a little bit. Everything is really worrying right now, to be honest. No one's gonna drop on top of my head, right? Are the doors around here supposed to do this?
No, I wouldn't say so.
Are you done?
So I guess that's all of them. Good timing too. I'm pretty well finished here. Come and meet me in the cockpit if you can. I'll be up in just two shakes of a koala. Oh, bugger. She's really pissed off now. 915 on Route 25. One of you need to shut down power to lower avionics immediately. She's got a mind of...
Wait. Come in, Rook 9. What is going on? Rook 13, I want you and Pawn 24 in lower avionics on the double.
Sir, the door is not responding.
What the fuck?
Let me try it remotely. Oh, remote door controls are not functioning, and neither are maintenance access points.
Well, figure it out. Now!
What the hell? The hatch door from lower avionics to the cockpit has just unlocked itself!
Oh, not now!
Six. That means you're up. Enter lower avionics from the cockpit and get Wade out of there.
It looks as though Rookline's vitals are decreasing. Whatever is happening in there, it's getting worse.
Don't worry, Wade, I'm coming. What the hell? I don't even... what's going on? Hurry up!
My God!
Stay focused, Six.
I can't!
Whoa, stay back! It looks like it only gets worse as you approach him. Return to the cockpit. We need a new plan.
Oh my, what is happening?
Alana, tell us you have a brilliant plan to get Wade out.
I think so. I mean, it's going to be dangerous, but I could remotely reverse the polarity of the Bishop's BUS to attract rather than-
We don't need details, just do it!
Okay, it's done. Be damned careful, Bishop. Your BUS will now attract every electrical current in that room.
Let's try this again, Six, and take it slowly.
What is even happening?
Oh my God! Forget slowly. Stick him with the nanites and get the hell out of there.
What is going on?
I'm dying too. Let's go, Wade. Wade, get to the cockpit quickly.
You don't need to tell me.
Okay,
twice.
Six, it's your turn. Time to go.
Well, even I got hurt there.
How are you feeling, Wade? And what exactly happened in there?
I'm actually not too bad, thanks to the Bishop. Bit of a headache, but,
what?
Nothing to worry about. But what happened? Your guess is truly as good as mine, boss. I was just about finished with the repairs to our autoguns when Samuel's computer core started surging electricity. I must have blacked out after that.
The medical nanites have repaired about 75% of the damage you were subjected to. The other 25% must be repaired by myself or Pawn 24, at your earliest convenience.
In other words, Wade, you've got more or less a clean bill of health. Good to still have you with us.
Thanks, Kieran. I'll come down once I've finished these repairs. And wait a second. Still have me with you. Are you saying I almost died?
What do you think?
No, no, of course not. The bishop was all over it from the get-go.
I knew he'd come to my rescue.
Rook 25 deserves all the praise. She fixed my suit. You're welcome, Wade, you sexy thing, you. Nah.
Did she now? Well, thanks, Alana. You can fix my suit any day.
Don't push it, Captain, or next time you fry. So can we talk about the elephant in the room now? These so-called system bugs that have been going unchecked since this morning.
I know. B did a pretty good job convincing me it was a virus, just before I was mistaken for popcorn. Whether it was Angeloff who somehow infected my girl, or the bastard who killed Pawn 7, someone is definitely pulling our strings.
I agree, but there's nothing we can do except hold it together and reach Ireland in one piece.
What about a lockdown of the crew?
No, I'm not prepared to go that far just yet. And to all of you, you may not want to mention this incident to anyone. We don't want to further scare the crew for no good reason.
Because holding back information from them was such a good idea last time.
Come on, Alana. Ease up.
No, it's fine. She's right. I admit that I should never have done that with Pawn 7, but this is different. They are already on edge, and I'd rather not have them start turning on each other. Just do what I say, Alana, please!
You're the boss.
Right. And Six, don't forget the Queen is still wanting to speak with you in Global Ops.
When you feel like it, meet with the Queen. Well, I won't feel like it for a little while, so let me hang around. What are you doing? In someone else's room? Is it Steve that's making me hear that, or is it the spot? This is weird.
Hello, Seeker.
Oh god, I don't know how long I can live with these hallucinations. Like, auditory hallucinations? What was I doing before? Oh yeah, I was going to the brig and getting the chips or something. Access chip locker. Right, is Angeloff being kept in here? Yeah. We're holding Angeloff in here, but we can't do anything with it. Chip locker. Didn't you open the chip locker? Hang on. I need some more energy anyway.
Since you skillfully smashed those F-35s all over Bulgaria, the damage to Zenlil is minimal and you won't need too many chips. Grab a bunch, then head up to Upper Avionics and the Upper Crawl. If you need more, you can always come back.
Okay, I'm full. I need to vent some energy. I think I need to heal myself first. Yeah, those hallucinations, the auditory kind, are kind of freaking me out. Are we all healed up? Oh god, I can do without it, really. It's kind of creepy. There we go. Transfer all. Grab a whole bunch. We're good. Okay. Did you say I needed to bring it to Upper Avionics? And the Upper Crawl. Upper Avionics, that's the place I need to... Right! That's where we saw the... Hang on. Oh, Alana's still here.
Nah, sorry Bishop, can't talk, too much to do. Why don't you head over to those busted chip banks, hmm? Upper Crawl and Upper Avionics, get going.
Wow, she's even bossing me around.
Oh, for Christ's sake, what?
I had nothing to do with Matthew's death. If that's what you're still pestering me about.
What is wrong with you? I want to know what you think of Rook 25.
Well, I really wanted the Blue Jays to win the World Series again. But that never happened, did it? And now they're gone. So, that's life.
Just answer the question. Or actually, so what about Pawn 7? What's your alibi? Hey, what if we get all buddy-buddy with him and say, yeah, I know, it's really too bad they're gone. We could try that.
You like baseball? Well, you used to like it. The only baseball we'll ever see again is from Japan. Rest in peace, MLB.
How does someone from Sweden like baseball? Yeah, Sweden? Is baseball a big thing in Sweden?
Norway. I am Norwegian.
I'm sorry.
We may be side by side, but we are not the same.
And you know, my sister's lived in Toronto most of her life, so it's not that big of a stretch.
I truly hope you're satisfied because I'm done talking. I don't use the P word that often, but will you please leave me alone now?
Farewell, my lovely. I wonder what it was like for authors in 1940.
What did you just say?
Farewell, my lovely. You should pick it up sometime. You know, when you're not investigating this murder.
Discover.
You don't know what you're doing, do you?
You kind of got that part, right? Seems like that's something. Is that a book? Damn it, I kind of messed up with Jens there just now. Oh well. What are you even-
Hey there, Bishop.
Hey there, Pod! Oh my god, there is just too many things to do everywhere. But first, let's go repair the chip banks. Upper avionics, right? And the upper crawl? Right now we're in the upper crawl. Yeah, the busted chips. That's what we were looking at. Somewhere down here? Oh? Oh, I thought something was on the ground. Never mind. Alright. Just a few more over here.
Hey, so while you're doing that, why don't you ask me about Pawn 7? The K told you to question everyone.
Alright, what can you tell me?
I can tell you that if I didn't let him break for lunch, he'd still be alive right now. I can also tell you that once I find them, whoever is responsible will never see daylight again. Pawn 7 was a good kid. A bit of a pain in the arse, sometimes, but most of these kids are.
You're the last to have seen him alive?
Other than whoever killed him, yes, I am. I told you before that I was working with him in the lower crawl. He was gone less than half an hour before the alarms went off. Needless to say, he's eating me up a little.
Don't beat yourself up. You're not to blame. And I know you can blame yourself if you like, but don't blame yourself, okay?
Don't patronize me, Bishop. And I know I'm not directly to blame. I'm not a half-wit. Just let me feel how I want to feel, or stay out of my way.
Well, suck it up then and keep it to yourself!
You're right. Of course you're right. So what I can't figure out is why did Seven go to Bishop 8's cabin in the first place?
She actually liked that.
I guess he could have decided to eat his lunch in there, but there was no evidence of food. Nothing. Just his body and that book.
About the book, what are your thoughts?
The Ancestor's Endless Drink. It's a Guardian Church-produced collection of pleasant stories. It's propaganda aimed to make them seem like their headway meetings actually heal people. I mean, hey, people can do whatever they please, but I'll stick to my heathenry. Thank you very much.
What does that mean, the Ancestor's Endless Drink?
The short answer is that it relates to their recently uncovered Prophecy of the Ancestors. Look it up on the info console if you want, but it's really just a load of nonsense.
Prophecy of the Ancestors. Did you say you are heathen? I don't know what that means.
Yes, Bishop. Learned everything I know from my father. That is, of course, after our mother left for the States with Kieran and took Catholicism with her. I'm not entirely sure why I just told you that.
So, because you like me. So, what exactly does it mean to be heathen?
Okay, we'll pretend you've been living under a rock for the past 20 years and missed the revolution of ancestral faith across Europe. Being a heathen means that I follow the ways of my pre-Christian ancestors. And that's not the same ancestors the Guardian Church talk about, by the way.
See, this is interesting because Alana and Kieran, despite being twins, they were raised apart, so they have different religions. Your father became heathen when your mother left?
No, not quite. It's a little complicated, but he's been with the faith since he was a kid. Our mother converted him to Catholicism, and for our sake, he agreed. It was for the souls of our children, I remember her saying to him before they split. Oh, nothing against Catholicism, but she was a real nasty woman. And with that, I'll leave you to it. I'm sure you don't need me talking in your head all day.
No, that was actually a very enjoyable conversation. I think we got to learn about each other quite a bit. Yeah, so I can't be... Don't patronize me, Bishop! I can't say anything nice to her, basically. That's why she doesn't say anything nice to people. It's not because she's not internally nice to them. She just thinks that doesn't help. Alright. You happy now, Alana? Oh, I thought you would have some words for me. Oh, okay, that's why. Are we good? Are we missing any? I don't think- Oh!
And there's the last one. I wish I could say, good job, but a monkey could replace a bunch of busted chips. So I'll say, thanks.
Thanks, Alana! You're just so wonderful and kind-hearted, and it's just a pleasure talking to you all the time. 20? I would say she likes me. Funny how that works out, huh? She started out as -1, worse than everyone else, and now she's at the top. Boom. That's what life is like. And with that, I'm actually gonna take a quick break here. And believe me, I don't want to take a break, but I gotta go to sleep. And believe me, I am so sucked in right now, I hardly want to take a break, but I gotta run, so... When we come back, we'll finish off whatever it is that needs to be finished off. Oh, we gotta look up that thing that Alana told us to look up. The prophecy of the ancient... whatever it was. I'll figure it out when I edit this. Alright, see you soon. Hey, we're back! It's like I never left. You probably didn't notice a thing. We'll continue on now. So, we should probably go back this way then, because I don't wanna go past night 15. Again, same thing there. So I believe now that we've finished repairing the stuff and saving Wade, there's... Okay. Interestingly enough, investigating who the traitor is actually a secondary objective. And talking to the Queen is the primary. We still have to discover who or what. What is farewell, my lovely? So, I'm not sure if that's something we can find just by looking around or... Guys?
Hey, Bishop. That was some pretty amazing work with Angelov. With 283 separate recorded incidents under his belt, it was about time someone put him behind bars.
God damn the computer brain of yours.
Yeah, well, it's a mixed blessing when it only allows for 1,533 hours of sleep a year.
That is not very much, Bishop, if you were wondering.
Oh, hey. Right, I guess you're wondering what else we found in the TS packet from London.
She has photographic memory, by the way. The Felix Stowe incident on the docks? Yes, tell me. I don't know about it, but okay, tell me.
Eyewitnesses claim 3 or 4 large transport vehicles left the Felixstowe docks only minutes before police arrived. They were headed for downtown when the police apparently, well, lost them.
Poof, vanished. A bunch of unmarked transports. You know, since the war you can barely let out a fart in London without 15 cameras seeing you do it. Followed by the police raining fire down on you.
Any solid leads at all?
No. Except to say the London police are likely holding something back. They claim they're dealing with a security breach of their mainframe and that automated monitoring systems have been unable to detect the vehicles. Something stinks. There is no way they just up and lost those trucks.
Whatever happened to those good old-fashioned police work? Without the cameras and the sensor arrays, those bubbies are useless.
That seems like a hacker to me.
Yes, but which one? We thought the same thing, and according to what we can tell, there are several high-profile hackers residing within the London area. Adrian Draper, Alvarez Famosa, and Jonathan Gonzalez are three of the big ones.
With the right tools, it could be any of them. And good luck finding one.
Whoa, I don't know. I feel like I don't know enough about this. Maybe I should say nothing.
So I'm told the bishop here has been tasked with investigating Pond 7. I'm assuming he has some questions he'd like to ask us, don't you, Bishop?
Really? Let's get it over with then. Ask away.
Have either of you been alone while on duty today?
Actually...
No, neither of us have. Not until after the incident took place. I sometimes wish we had those suits the Swedes wear, you know.
Are we lying here? Don't change the subject. Pawn 51 was saying something.
No, she wasn't saying that.
Hey, relax. We've got nothing to hide. I went to the washroom, actually. Right around when it happened. But it's a straight shot from Global Ops. The cabins are on a different level altogether.
I kind of want to say both, but why would you lie for no reason, Pawn 62?
I don't know. I guess I didn't want you thinking Kendra had anything to do with this. She's a good kid.
And we're all a little stressed out today. Can you really blame him?
So you guys know nothing. Who should I speak to next?
Maybe talk to Rook 25, Pawn 32, or Pawn 4. They were all working with Pawn 7 this morning in the hangar bay.
I talked to them already. Rook 25 was actually with Pawn 7 last, in the lower crawl. Why does Bishop keep highlighting that? Do you want to suggest that Alana did it?
I hope you're not suggesting that Rook 25 could be suspect. Because that's simply impossible. Not her. Never.
Are we done here, Bishop? You know we're not involved.
What about Pawn 32 then? What's her story?
Pawn 32 has been here for over 3 years now. She was just married 6 months ago. Pawn 7 and several others actually went to the wedding. Just last week she was telling me she and her husband are trying for their first kid.
I remember, what did she say earlier? Something about how Carla told her about how Carol wanted to kill me, which she's not supposed to know, so I'm a little bit curious about that. Anyway, so out of those three, Pawn 4 is the most suspect?
Wait, I didn't say that. Neither did he. All we're saying is Pawn 4 is annoying. It certainly doesn't mean we think he killed anyone.
Wait a second. Why in the hell is the Knight of 15 giving you the task of interrogating her crew anyway? It does not seem right, does it? I mean, you barely know any of us.
That is precisely why I am the right choice, but please shut up, 62. She was talking.
Oh, you really shouldn't have said that.
So, Bishop, is this how you want to make a first impression? Running around the ship, making people point the fingers and accusing us all of murder? I'm not going to sit around here and listen to this. I'm sorry, Kendra, but I don't think I can play after all. Something has put me in a foul mood. I think I will go back to work. There's a plenty to go through from the London to TS pack.
I should have warned you. He's got a pretty decent temper. I guess I'll join him, get some work done. It's probably best if you just lay off for a while. Let him cool down.
Well, I was bound to piss someone off here and there, right? You can't... Well, I guess that's realistic in a way. You can't make everyone happy. Although I do regret that wording a little bit. I didn't want to say shut up. I just wanted him to be quiet. Why does he keep interrupting people?
Hey, I'm sorry about that.
It's fine. I understand. We've got a lot to do anyway. Maybe we can play some more tonight.
Thanks. And sure.
Aww. I just walked right into Global Ops. But that's okay. We're not done here yet. We're not done. We should go find a console. Oh god, can someone fix this stuff around here? Everything is just going haywire. Hello? What are you doing, Adele? No comment? Alright. Adele is a follower of the Guardian Church. Just thought we should point that out. Who else is? Kieran? Kieran is one. And Pawn 32 is also one.
Nah, sorry, Bishop. Can't talk. Too much to do.
Hey, I helped you with those chips. You can't give me 2 minutes?
You helped me, did you? A peg-legged elephant could have done what you did. Now go. Go find out who killed Matthew.
Oh, wow. I like her, but she's hard to get along with. She's hard to get along with, really. But like Patricia said, she's probably someone who makes for an excellent boss. So Patricia's doing her thing here, not being distracted. Things here are damaged. How do we find out? Okay, hang on. We need to find an information console. Yeah, things here were really weird earlier. The colors were all messed up. Clothing washer? You have your clothing washer right next to the beds? That's innovative, I guess. I guess because we're always on a spaceship, people have all sorts of family mementos to keep them going. What is this anyway? Is this like people's stuff? There's numbers on them. 9, 8. Oh, hang on! Hang on. I can drop this now. I don't need this. Can I just delete them? Sure. That's some space. When I absorbed the book just now, there was a title. A New Earth. Modern Cooking, Bye-Bye Sugar. Hey, we might be able to find the book here. Ah! Farewell, my lovely! Pawn 32. Speak to Pawn 4 again first, or confront Pawn 32 directly. What? Why are we confronting someone based on the fact that it says Pawn 32 behind the book? That's a little... The Secret History of the LDS. Oh. The Resource Wars, a feud of utility. This is Pawn 32's locker. I'm just recycling things from people's lockers now. Evidence of Guardian influence. What? Pawn 19. Carla. The drawing of the three. Pawn 11. Amen, the awakening. Pawn 51. 51 is Kendra, right? Hang on. Yeah, Kendra. Well,
we've almost got them all. Just take it easy.
I don't know, this machine, it sort of makes me nervous. Oh, and hey, Bishop.
Everything, it seems, makes you nervous.
What's that supposed to mean? Are you saying you think I killed Pawn 7? Because I didn't have anything to do with that. I was in mission ops the whole time. Ask anyone, really, anyone at all.
Maybe we should sedate him.
No, Kieran, bad Kieran. Just take it easy, okay? Nobody is accusing anyone of anything.
I'm sorry, it doesn't matter. So, Bishop, thanks for coming to see me. I'm just, you know, getting these huge fragments taken out of me. The doc here says those experimental bullets should have blown me to bits. It didn't hurt at all. No, not one bit. Not at all. Nope. No. No siree. No. Have you ever been shot before, Bishop? I'll bet you have.
Of course, do I say of course I am because I am Bishop 6, or do I say I've sprained my ankle before because I'm me? I've sprained my ankle before. Does that count?
Funny and air-cooled. Wow. I sure lucked out joining this crew. You're all so nice. And all I had to do was survive Bishop 8 for a few months.
Is there something wrong with your vocal cords? They seem to vibrate far too often, and at an incredible rate.
I was going to tell
Nervous?
You to stop drooling on the bishop, but yours is better.
Haha, real funny, guys. Thanks a lot. So, Doc, are we done here? I'd like to head back to Mission Ops, see if Rook 9 or Pawn 19 need my help.
Stop calling me Doc. The remaining bullet fragments have been removed, and the nanites forcibly flushed from your system, as requested. So yes, Pawn 12, we are done here. Can you please tell Pawn 1 that we are ready for him?
Yep, sure, of course. Hey, Gary, looks like you're up. It doesn't hurt, really, it doesn't. I didn't feel a thing, and I was expecting to feel so much pain.
Be quiet, 12. Please,
sorry.
Not now.
Well, if you want to come talk, Bishop, come see me in Mission Ops. Whatever.
Hey, number one.
He's in love with me.
Number one.
You have the bridge, number one.
Please, guys. Yeah, for the 10th time, I get it. Just like Riker. Ha ha. My head is killing me, and I'm grumpy as hell. Can we just get this over with so I can go lay down?
Sorry, you're right.
Lay down here and try to relax.
Remember, Gary and David earlier got injured.
Brain cancer or something. I don't want to know about it.
How long is that gonna take? Can I stick around or should I go?
How long is this gonna take?
Almost there. Just let it work.
And hey, Bishop. thanks for saving my life.
Touching, cowboy. Touching.
What is that supposed to mean?
Alan Rickman.
Who?
Never mind.
Kieran and his old school movies. Maybe I'll hang around for a little bit.
Okay, there we go. All done.
Alright.
My head still feels like it's splitting in half.
That is to be expected, considering your injuries. I will inform Rook 25 that you will be taking the afternoon off.
Thanks. Oh, and Bishop, you'll have to speak with me tomorrow if you want to ask about Pawn 7. I really need to lay down.
Take care of yourself, Gary.
Yeah, I'll try.
Oh, no. No way, Bishop. I don't want to hear any more about where you're really from or how your brain is a freak show. I really don't need this.
I apologize for her attitude, Bishop. She's having a hard time processing what happened earlier with what you told us and the brain scan.
Everything I told you was the truth. Kieran can handle it.
The only logical options in my head are to either believe what you've told us, or believe that you found a way to manipulate the equipment read from the brain scan. It was a joke, perhaps.
No joke, but I don't know if I can trust you.
Yes, I can understand that. Perhaps trust will come in time. I am curious about one thing, Bishop. If there are other versions of you in our world, other players, like yourself. Does each of you play along a different timeline? A different instance of this dimension?
Yes, something like that.
So there are variations of this world, where Zenlil has been destroyed. Where you have died, and this well-funded enemy of yours has won. And of course, you only need to load and try again. It's truly fascinating, right? And so we are clear. You can tell your people I will remain quiet about what I know. If you wish to tell others in this world, that is your choice. You may want to keep in mind that even with the brain scan as proof, nobody else will believe you. Take care, Otherworlder. And try to keep an eye on your back. It is likely about to be stabbed.
Ooh, ominous. Well, thank you, Kieran. Thank you for believing in me. But I'm not too worried because, like you said, if anything goes south, I can reload, right? Well, Mika's just like, she doesn't want to talk to me anymore. We can't go here anymore probably because of the whole thing with Wade. Because this is right below the cockpit, right? Fair enough. I guess our business here is done. Thank you, Kieran. Thank you, Mika. Oh, I really shouldn't be disturbing him.
Come on, I appreciate you saving my life and all, but give me a break. I did not kill Pawn 7. What else do you want?
Sorry, was just making sure you're okay.
No, I'm sorry, and I'll be fine. A little sleep will do me good. All right, it's been great. Wake me up when we hit BC.
Sounds good. Who's here? Steve. Is Steve resting as well? I don't know where Steve is anymore. Hey, I never got to use this, food transporter. I wonder if we'll get a chance to. Anyway, there's an info console right here. So what did I want to search? Prophecy of the Ancestors, was it? No? Ancestors. Oh, there's a lot of stuff. What is this? 8 of 21. Someone's biography? There's a lot of mysterious articles here, especially to do with the number 21 that I'm not sure what to make of right now. How about Heathen? I can't seem to find what Alana was talking about. No? Really? Ancestor without the S? Nothing! Was it a prophecy? Prophecy of the Ancestors? Oh well. That's okay. I mean, like I said, it's all extra, so... Right? Nobody's here? Kirill? Is Kirill conscious anymore, or is he, like, just lying inside? Well, I don't suppose anything else is going on around here. Except for Alana getting pissed at me. Oh! There was one spot that I think I forgot to visit.
Thanks for stopping Angelov and those mercs. He was pretty hairy there for a minute.
Yeah, no problem. This area here, I kept missing it. I think this is where Alana and Matthew was working. The lower crawl? What is this? Just some machinery? Hang on, how come I can't interact with it? I have space. Let me vent a little bit. Can't interact with it. Okay. That's fine, I guess. We should go look for Patricia. Where did we see her again? I know we saw her somewhere, but I can't remember where. Anyone in my room? Nope. Hey, Steve.
Hello, Bishop.
That's it? You're sitting alone in this room by yourself. You're standing here. Oh yeah, I'm getting those weird messages again. Security lockdown initiated. Oh god. Okay, so let's try to find where Patricia is. Wasn't she by the hangar? Yeah, speak to Pawn 4 first. Or, confront Pawn 32 directly. What? What did it say just now? It said... Dayside? Not the side, but like D-E-I-C-I-D-E? What was that? I can talk to Jens, or I can talk to... Patricia. Let's see here.
I'm really very busy right now. Do you mind?
What? It was you. You killed Pawn 7.
I did what? And where does this notion come from?
I don't know. I'm not sure how... So why did you do it, Did he catch you speaking to Angelov?
What is this? Whatever you think you know, Bishop, please. It's wrong. Someone is lying to you.
You bitch. Call them off my sister. The Bishop knows what you did to Matthew. How you cracked his skull open and then smiled as he died at your feet. Admit it! Tell the Bishop what you did!
What is your problem for? I thought... Oh, wait. I see now. If you accuse me, then there's no way to prove you wrong, is that it? We were together all day. It sure would get you out of being investigated, wouldn't it?
Don't listen to her, Bishop. She's poison. I followed her into Bishop 8's old cabin and found her standing over his body. She...
That's a lie. Both of you, shut up!
Why would he make that up?
Because he's paranoid. Insanely paranoid. He's also claustrophobic and would do anything to get out of an investigation.
She's lying through her teeth. Just lock her away already. She said she was going to have them kill my sister.
Your sister?
Did I stutter? Sister. Yes, Bishop. She tried to silence me by saying the people she works for could murder the only person I give a damn about.
I honestly have no words. If either of you believe any of this, you're just as crazy as he is.
Rook 25, control your people.
Yes, sir. Okay, that's enough. I have a big enough headache as it is, and neither of you can prove a damn thing. So drop it. You can squabble and bitch to the investigators in Ireland.
Alana, please, you can't just ignore this.
Oh, I'm not. If you want to stay within eyeshot of Pawn 32, by all means do so.
But you have to investigate. At least go through her stuff. Or look for a bomb or something?
Get back to work!
Forget it! I'm done with you people.
Thank you.
Don't thank me yet. I'm not entirely ruling him out. Get back to work!
Okay, I see what happened. Jens didn't want to outright point out who he thinks is the murderer, which is why he mentioned that book in his locker. So when I went to see his locker and picked the book up, I saw the paper that said Pawn 32 because he wanted to tell me he thinks Pawn 32 is the killer. And now, I'm not so sure what's up anymore. I think I'm gonna go talk to Jens. Where did he run off to? This is difficult because Jens does not strike me as the kind of guy to lie for no reason. Oh, that's that. We can't talk to him, and we can't talk to Patricia. I do want to search that word that we just saw. Oh, what? I don't know what that means, but I guess we can keep on a lookout. What does that mean? Are we looking for another word? Oh no. Maybe I should talk to Alana again. Oh! Things are getting pretty tense around here though. It's obvious that Jens and Patricia can't work together again. And actually, I'm not sure if we can do anything anymore, because... That's it. Patricia did say that she couldn't have an alibi because she was just wandering around all morning. But so was Jens. Jens says that he saw her over Pawn 7's body.
I have another minute. I wanted to ask you one more thing.
Sure. What's on your mind?
It is about the Guardian Church. I was only wondering what your affiliation is, if any. Are you a member?
Why do you want to know?
Because I've been a member for many years. I was hoping to find another ally against Alana's teasing. Someone who understands the church and their message of unity.
I don't know what the Guardian Church is.
I find that hard to believe, to be honest, but okay, I suppose then I will let you return to work. I truly hope that you and I can become friends.
What are you implying? Are you implying that we can't be friends if we're not the same religion? Oh, don't do this to me, please. Well, Kieran likes me. Alana likes me. He shouldn't be surprised that I don't know about the Guardian Church, though, because I'm a... What did he call me? An other... Over... Otherworlder? Yeah, so he shouldn't be surprised. Where's David? No, David is in Global Ops. Oh no, you're right here.
Bishop, hey! I was hoping you'd come talk to me.
I was just wondering how you're feeling.
Well, I'm fine. Thanks for asking. Those nanites are creepy, but they sure did the trick. Did you know the original version of the medical nanite was principally developed by David Shelter himself? So too was your CMC, your PCU, and your BUS. If any of it malfunctioned, you'd be SOL.
Why were you hoping I'd come to talk to you?
I don't know. I just like hanging out with you, I guess.
Yeah.
I hope that's all right. Is it all right to hang out with you?
Yes, of course it is.
Good! Yeah! Well, I think we're gonna be great friends, you and I. So, can I ask you something? Friend? Oh man, that's just crazy just to say it out loud.
Sure, friend.
Really? Okay. Do you guys know how Kirill knew about Matt? I'm sorry, Pawn 7? His name was Matt Wilson, his real name. But anyway, do you know how Kirill knew about his death?
Should I tell him? I mean, basically everybody knows about it already. Yes, someone on board Zenlil was working with him.
One of us? Right, the same person who killed Pawn 7. So who was it then? Do you know?
That's what I'm trying to find out.
You can't possibly think I had anything to do with his death, can you? It's not right. It's not possible, I mean. I mean, I'm not nervous because I'm doing anything incriminating or would insinuate anything of my involvement in the case. I mean, I was right here in Mission Ops when it happened. Ask Magnet 15, ask anyone. I didn't do it.
Any idea who may have had reason to kill him?
No, of course not. I mean, Rook 25 and him used to argue all the time, but it was always good-natured. He was quiet and didn't have a lot of good friends, but Pawn 7 was generally liked by everyone.
What did you personally think of Pawn 7?
I liked him. We used to talk about Bishop statistics. You know, how many career kills versus incaps, lives saved, property damage, that sort of thing. He's the only one who understood that side of me.
The gamers? Are there Bishop trading cards or something?
No. Well, yeah, there are, but no, nothing too mainstream. You know, it's kind of on the sideline, kind of like a cult thing in the crowd, you know, nothing hippie, but everything's on the VR servers, Bishop. All the stats you could ever want.
A little bit of a geek. Are we done here? All right. I don't feel like,
Hello, Bishop.
Hi. I feel like the questions... I'm not really asking the right questions, because questions like, so, who do you think killed Pawn 7? That's just kind of like introducing people's own biases into the investigation. So I'm not sure how helpful that really is.
Bishop.
Hi. Is there anyone who I haven't talked to yet? I feel like I've talked to everybody already. How about Wade? Wade? Nope, he's busy piloting. Okay, I guess I'm gonna walk around the ship once more and see if anyone wants to talk. If nobody wants to talk, then we'll meet right back at Global Ops.